Good morning. In the previous video, I have discussed the basic Rankine cycle, the TS diagram, and the improvements in Rankine cycle, namely the reheating and regeneration process. And we have drawn the circuit for a Rankine cycle with reheat. So this was the progress in the previous video. I would like to continue here from where we have stopped yesterday's video. Okay. So I have taken the Rankine cycle with the reheating. Okay. So a boiler, a high pressure turbine, low pressure turbine, followed by a condenser. Okay. Then it is pumped back to the boiler. So in between the stages of expansion, we have the process of reheating. So this is what we have discussed yesterday. Today I am going to draw the TS diagram. Okay. So this is the TS diagram we have drawn for a simple cycle, Rankine cycle. Now I am going to draw for a reheat cycle. Okay. So let me now name the different state points here. So at the inlet it is water, so state number 1. Okay. And at the outlet of the boiler it is steam. Okay, that steam is supplied to the high pressure turbine, where the steam is partially expanded. Okay. So its state changes from 2 to 3. Then it is heated, reheated in the boiler. So at constant pressure, so its state changes from 3 to 4. 3 to 4 is the process of reheating at constant pressure. Then after reheating, it enters at state 4, it expands fully up to state 5. Okay. Then from 5 to 6, it is condensed. Then the condensate is pumped back. 6 to 1, it is pumped back to the boiler. So for this, the diagram will be something like this. TS diagram. Okay. So I have already told you to draw these two curves, which represents the saturated liquid line and saturated vapor line, and different regions, liquid, the wet region, then the vapor region or the gas region. So this is what the TS, the information you have to give in the TS diagram. Now to draw the reheat cycle, there are going to be three pressures. One is the boiler pressure, next one is the intermediate pressure, the pressure between high pressure and the low pressure. Process is taking place at constant pressure. So this process reheating is taking place at constant pressure. Then the steam is condensed at the condenser pressure. So condenser pressure is one, is the lowest pressure. Then the intermediate pressure between the stages of expansion. Then the high pressure is the boiler side. So let me draw these three pressure lines first. These three are the pressure lines. So remember, in a simple cycle we had only two pressure lines. One is the evaporator pressure or the boiler pressure, next one is the low pressure, is the condenser pressure. Here I have one more additional pressure, is the intermediate pressure between the stages of expansion. So to begin with, okay, I will start with here, say 2, where which is the inlet to the high pressure boiler. So let us assume it is superheated somewhere here. Okay, very similar to simple Rankine cycle, I will start here too. Okay. So initially it is expanded something like this isentropically, okay, up to say some point 3. So I have shown here 3. Okay. Then 3 to 4 is constant pressure reheating. So constant pressure reheating. So the process will proceed like this. So normally the temperature, inlet temperature for both the turbines will be same, because of the metallurgical limit of the turbine blades, turbine material. Okay. So it is usual to limit the temperature, same temperatures. Okay. Then 4 to 5 will take place, the expansion will take place isentropically in low pressure turbine. So the steam will expand something like this isentropically, 4 to 5. Okay. Now after 5, the steam after expanding the turbine goes to the condenser, where it condenses, which means liquid, vapor turns to liquid. So it takes place at constant pressure. So superheated vapor comes to the saturated or dry vapor, then it condenses. The combination of liquid and vapor, finally it comes here, fully saturated liquid, say 5 to 6. Okay, now from 6 to 1 is the boiler. Okay, so boiler pressure is the high pressure, so it is going to be something like this, isentropically compressed or pumped. Okay, pressure is raised. This is how the reheat cycle, the TS diagram will be for a reheat Rankine cycle. So this is the Rankine cycle with reheat. Rankine cycle with reheat. Okay, so the process here. So you can now show the process. So for this process 1 to 2, what is that process 1 to 2? It is in the boiler. Okay, so it is constant pressure heat addition. Constant pressure heat addition. Then process 2 to 3 is isentropic expansion. Isentropic expansion in the high pressure turbine. High pressure turbine. Then 3 to 4. It is the process of reheating. Okay, so it is again constant pressure heat addition. So here you have two heat addition process. One is taking place in the boiler, so this process is taking place in the boiler B, whereas the reheat take place in a reheater R. So that is this process, a reheater, a reheating process. Then 4 to 5 again is expansion, isentropic expansion in the low pressure turbine, okay. Then 5 to 6, it is the condensation process. Condensation, during condensation vapor turns to liquid, so it has to be cooled, or the heat rejection takes place. So it is known as constant pressure heat rejection. Constant pressure heat rejection. It is taking place in the condenser. Okay, and 6 to 1 is the pumping process. So it is isentropic compression. Pressurized water is pressurized, so it is isentropic compression. Okay, in the pump. So now we can see here the difference between these two cycles. Okay, so here the benefit of reheating, I have told you, turbine work is increased. So here let us see, suppose if there is no reheat process, so then what would have been the change here? You see, instead of having two stages, the steam would have expanded in a single stage, which means instead of reheating along 3-4 and then expanding low pressure turbine, the steam would have expanded something like this, isentropically, from high pressure to low pressure. Let me call this as a 5 dash some point. Okay, so the steam would have expanded from here to here. Okay, so what is the problem? You can see here, if the steam would have expanded between 3 to 5 dash, then you have the presence of moisture, the liquid particles, which leads to the corrosion. That is what we have told here. Okay, superheating or reheating, we can remove the moisture content. So here it is fully expanding in the gaseous phase or the vapor phase, okay, vapor region. So there is no moisture content in the steam, so it will not corrode the boiler turbine blades. That is the own advantage of having superheating or reheating. You can expand in fully in the vapor region. The next thing is the work done is increased. We have discussed in the previous video, turbine work is increased. How the turbine work is increased, you can see. Okay, if there is no reheat, the turbine work will be equal to, okay, H2 minus H5 dash. So this is the turbine work without reheat from here to here. So with reheat or with reheating, with reheating. What is the change? The turbine work has now become as H2 minus H3. That work we have got from the high pressure turbine, H2 minus H3. Then plus, in addition to that, we will be having plus, okay, this work, H4 minus H5. H4 minus H5. So, when you compare these two works, so I will call this as a 1, this as 2. What is the meaning? Turbine work 1 means it is without reheat. Turbine work 2 means it is with reheat. If you compare these two, it is obvious that, okay, the turbine work with reheat will be greater than turbine work without reheat. Okay, so this much work will be would have been got without reheat. With reheat, we have this plus this. So that is what I have done here. Okay, so I have the turbine work 2 is greater than turbine. So I have, this is the concept of Rankine cycle with reheating process. So you have two advantages. One is you can eliminate the moisture content, so you can prevent the corrosion of the turbine blades. Then you can increase the work output or the turbine work. So if you increase the turbine work, obviously the efficiency of the Rankine cycle, what you have discussed in the previous video, so the turbine work will increase, so efficiency will also improve. So this is about the Rankine cycle with reheat. So the next topic will be on Rankine cycle with regeneration. Okay. Rankine cycle with regeneration. So regeneration, we have defined, it is nothing but the process of preheating, okay, the feed water. It is the process of preheating the feed water before supplying that to the turbine. Okay, so how we are going to do here? Okay, how we are going to preheat water? Okay, so I will again draw the flow diagram, flow circuit. First I have a boiler, okay, so in which heat is added, so the water is converted to steam. So water is converted to steam in the boiler. Then this steam is taken to the turbine. Is taken to the turbine, okay, T. Then the steam is condensed. So I am now drawing the simple Rankine cycle. In the condenser you had some cooling water supply, so the steam will condense, then it will be pumped. So up to this there is no change, okay, you can think of the same basic Rankine cycle. So you have a pump here. Now the change is, okay, I am going to bleed or take some steam after it has expanded partially. So I repeat, so I am going to take or tap some amount of steam after it has expanded. So you can see the steam has expanded up to this stage. It is not full expansion, is from say from here to here. So in between, halfway, okay, I am tapping, I am removing some portion of the steam, and I will take that steam to a device. Okay, this is a device, okay, where that steam will mix with the condensate coming from the condenser. I repeat, already you have the presence of condensate, okay, from the condenser, and that has to be pumped back to the boiler. So that is a separate circuit, flow path. So I am now taking or tapping or bleeding out some of the steam which has been partially expanded. Okay, that is taken to the device, one device. Okay, so where in that device the steam, okay, that expanded steam, bleeded steam, tapped steam will be mixing with the condensate. condensate, it is nothing but hot water, okay, a very high temperature, okay. So those will mix. What happens now? The condensate temperature, this is a very high temperature, this will be somewhat at lower temperature when compared to the steam. So when they mix, steam will condense and you have a pure the liquid form will be the output of this system, okay. So both will mix and you have here the feed water at an elevated temperature, and that is again pumped. So you have one more pump, it is pumped and it is given to the boiler, something like this, okay. So only this is new. So the pump is already there, okay. Now instead of having one pump, I have two pumps here, pump one, pump two, okay. In between pump there is a device. That device is known as feed water heater, feed water heater. So this device is known as feed water heater, feed water heater. Feed water, you know, the water supply to the boiler, and that water is being heated, so it is known as feed water heater. How it is heated? The feed water is heated by making use of the partially expanded steam, then it is expanded. So this is how the flow diagram will be, or circuit diagram, flow circuit diagram will be for a Rankine cycle with regeneration, okay. Now let me draw the TS diagram, okay. So already we are told regeneration is nothing but a process of heating, preheating, in order to reduce the heat supply. I want to reduce the heat supply in order to improve the Rankine cycle efficiency. So now let me assign the state points as before. It enters at water, leaves at steam. That steam is given to the turbine. Now I will take the third point here, because there is a partial expansion, okay, in between. So some change, state change take place because of the tapping of the steam here. So 3, then the complete expansion, it is 4, then after condensation it is 5, then after pumping I have 6, then you see the water is coming after pumping, it is at state 6, it is mixing with steam at 3. So at the outlet of the feed water the state changes, it is 7, okay, and after pumping 7 to 1. So this is how the state points is going to vary. So let us now draw the TS diagram. Okay, so I have the saturated liquid line and vapor line, okay. Now very similar to this process, I have a boiler pressure, then the steam which is being tapped at some pressure, then the exit pressure. So I will be having 3 pressure lines. I will start from here. So 2 to 3, the expansion, what we did for the Rankine cycle with reheat, same thing I will put start with here. Let us assume the steam is superheated, so it is going to expand from here, okay. So steam will expand up to say third point. So I will assume it is saturated vapor here. So 2 to 3, okay. After 3 it is continuously expanding, okay, steam is expanding, so it will expand. So here there is no reheat, so it will fall, it will expand in the wet region, okay. 3 to 4. So in between I am having the point 3, which means I am bleeding some steam at a pressure, okay, at 3, partially expanded. It has already expanded, undergone expansion process. After that I am bleeding out, okay. So after 4 you see the condensation process take place, so vapor turns to liquid up to this point, say 5 to 6, there is a pumping process. Pressure, the water, the condensate will be pressurized. So say from something like this, 5 to 6, this process. Then what happens here? This 6 will mix with the steam which is taken, bleeded out at 3. So it is coming here. Both will mix, this and this will mix. So condensation takes place. This is at steam, this is water, so both mix, so condensation of the steam takes place. So I have a point somewhere here, this, namely the 7th point. 7 to 1, again a pump is there, pressure is going to rise, so we will have something like this. Then heat is added in the boiler. So this is how the process of regeneration is going to be in TS diagram. So what is the benefit of regeneration? Already we have told that in regeneration process the heat added is going to be reduced, so that the efficiency of the Rankine cycle will improve. So how we can explain here with this TS diagram, it is possible. Okay, so I will first write QS, okay, with regenerator. Okay, what is the amount of heat added? So this is the TS diagram with regenerator. So it enters at 1 and leaves at 2. It is the boiler, okay, where the heat is being added. So the heat added will be H2 minus H1. Understood? Heat added in the boiler. Okay. Suppose if there is no regeneration, without regeneration. Okay. So what is the process? What is the heat added? You can see here. Okay, if there is no regeneration, this is the process of regeneration. Regeneration takes place in the feed water heater, which means 6 and 3 mixes, and at the outlet I have the 7. So this is where the regeneration takes place. So if there is no regeneration, I would have supplied the heat from here, say somewhere starting from here. Okay, it will be somewhere here. So it goes here. So roughly I can say it will be H2 minus H6. Up to this point I have to somewhere here, okay, I will approximate that 6 H6, okay, H2 minus H6. So it is now evident. Okay, so the value of H2 minus I need only this much of heat, okay, from here to here, this point to this point with regenerated. Without regenerated, from here to here. So obviously you can write H2 minus H1 is less than H2 minus H6, which means the heat with regeneration is less than heat without regeneration. Okay, so which means I have by incorporating the regenerator, I have reduced the heat supply. So Rankine cycle efficiency improve. So this is the idea behind the modification, namely regeneration. So I hope you have understood the concept of basic Rankine cycle with reheat, and Rankine cycle with regeneration. Okay. So in Rankine cycle with reheat, what we have done is we have tried to increase the turbine work to increase the Rankine cycle efficiency. In the case of Rankine cycle with regeneration, we have tried to reduce the heat supplied in the boiler by recovering some of the heat from the steam after it has expanded partially to preheat the water before it is supplied to the boiler. Okay, so with this I will stop this lecture, and we will continue in the next video. Thank you.